Alright, I think I figured out what's wrong. I just need to use my mouse.
Features a very special guest, journalist, broadcaster, and all-round truth seeker, Patrick Bannon.
Good evening, Wayne.
You excited to join us tonight?
I'm excited, Wayne. Can't say I'm excited about all this dust, though. It plays havoc with my allergies.
Now, Patrick. Oh, what's that, love? Oh, my. My, Patrick. I'm hearing from the spirit world. I'm hearing something that might shake your world to its very foundation. Is it true that you are, in fact, the one and only son of Graham Bannon?
Well, yeah, I mean, everyone knows that, yeah.
The EMF reading is off the charts!
And, of course, we're joined, as usual, by our paranormal investigator and supernatural scientist, Dr. Ahmed.
Excuse me, Dr. Ahmed, what is an EMF?
Forgive me, Mr. Bannon, I'm so sorry. Sometimes I forget that not everyone is as well-versed in the terminology as myself and Mr. Spirit Whistle here. So, EMF stands for Electric Magnetic Field. Essentially, it is a measurable energy signature given off by all forms of spectral phenomena.
And that thing being off the charts, is that a good thing or is that a bad thing for us?
Well, I mean, higher tends to mean that there is either a stronger presence or even more presences. Mm. And of course, seeing that we're in the business of hunting ghosts, I say yes, it's definitely a good thing, Patrick.
Words to trust there, Mr. Bannon. Our doctor here is the foremost expert in metaphysical science. What do you have for us this evening, Pet?
Well, I've actually stumbled onto something of a breakthrough here, Wayne. I've managed to actually expand the light spectrum visible to the human eye by refracting it through a specially vibrated prism. This cutting-edge technology actually allows me to see into the spirit world.
Ah, yes! Let's get the ghost cam switched on!
Oscillating optoelectronics.
Boom!
Ah! What was that for?
Branching, oscillating octahedral optoelectronics.
Oh, yes, exactly. That's what I said. But of course, I do need a shorter name for that now, don't I?
Boom!
Ah! Please stop doing that.
Yes, Mr. Banner, please do stop scaring poor Dr. Ahmed. Please continue, Doctor.
Thank you, Mr. Spirit Whistle. So, tonight, we will be utilizing my standard surveillance kit, which of course includes night vision capabilities, should we come into any problematic darkness, let's say. Oh, and additionally, I have taken the liberty of installing my branching up new devices all over the building. Tonight, we might actually be able to broadcast the image of a ghost for the very first time.
Oh, exciting stuff! Now, Patrick, your father built this place at the height of his illustrious career.
That's right.
The year was 1956. Hot off his success in music hall venues and comedy clubs around the country, Graham Bannon suddenly produces a TV script. A script that blows the mind of studio execs and leaves them scrapping over who will get to make it.
It was called Dying is Another Man's Job and starred Graham as a daring do-gooder, Percival Peril. It was said to be a tour de force for your father, launching him to superstardom.
Ah, but it was to be the start of something much more sinister. Three disasters struck, each more calamitous than the last. And shortly after the tragic events that Graham Bannon suddenly disappeared from the limelight, never to be seen.
It broke him. This place, the curse. My father had it all. Charm, talent, the weaselish good looks of a meerkat or some sort of stoat animal. The fate came in and cruelly stole it all away.
Built in 57, the Bannon sound stage was to be the home of a brand new televisual sensation of a scale never seen on our screens before.
For that damned woman.
Ah! The spirit! Doomed to roam the wings and the halls forevermore. An unfortunate accident, a raging inferno, and tragic loss of life. Left these walls cursed forever.
Of course, production was shut down following Marie Murphy's mysterious passing. And since then, there have been misguided attempts to make use of this very building. None survived.
What?
Succeeded. None succeeded. Sorry, succeeded.
We'll investigate those tales as we delve deep into the ruins of this once flourishing enterprise. Wait, wait! Who's there? A spirit! A spirit beckons!
We can test out the branching octahedral oscillating optoelectronics!
We'll want that first ghost effect any second now. The script calls for them to go to the costume room first. So when the button lights up, hit the coat hanger button at the bottom there.
Everyone, shh! Any moment now, they speak to me, Lord. Oh my goodness!
That's it. Now Wayne will run with the script and they'll move on to the next location.
Please, Prince.
Where does our journey lead us? Show me. Did you see that? He throws
some
man.
Must be some sort of a poltergeist.
Don't waste a tie. The spirit must be showing us where to go.
If it designed anything to go by, it's a cry for help. come on, Wayne, must handle the spirits.
Its failed harness costume was created. It was the home of the late costume designer Marie Murphy, one of the suspects in this insidious mystery. And, most terrifying of all, it contains dangerous amounts of noxious fabric.
Here we are, Patrick, our first stop, the wardrobe department. Why is it you think the spirits brought us here first?
Well, makes a lot of sense, Wayne. Many people would say that this is where the accident was caused.
With that injured stuntman, Brent Backflay.
That's exactly right.
Well, say more, say more.
Well, wouldn't like to point fingers, Wayne. But if I were going to, and I am going to, I'd point all eight of mine and my thumbs squarely at Marie Murphy.
The costume designer?
The very same. In this room, Wayne, at that desk, probably, she sat there making the costumes for the show. The costume with a harness that failed and plunged an innocent man to his death.
Brent Backflip didn't die though, did he?
What? He didn't die, no. But the same plunge to his death sounds better than saying plunge to multiple comminuted fractures.
And what do you think happened to the harness?
Well, I wouldn't like to speculate, Wade. But if I were going to, and I am going to, I'd say poor workmanship, laziness, foolhardiness. Basically, she dropped the ball, and the ball was a man.
Such a small thing can have dire consequences. A seemingly insignificant thing like the costume girl can mean life or death.
Absolutely. Look, we all make mistakes, but sometimes mistakes cost lives, or in this case, legs.
We have Dally Patrick, the dead. Urge us forward. Give us a sign. Do you hear that, Patrick?
Yeah, I can hear something, actually.
Sounds to me like an old song, probably from the show itself.
You're right. It's the theme tune to Dad's old show. He used to hum it all the time while he was reading and then burning all of his fan mail.
Well, there's no time to lose. Let's go see what this spectral sign entails.
Prop store was the lair of Cedric Sloan, master prop maker on Bannon's failed production. After Brent Backflip's accident, rumors concerning the prop dumbbells shone the cold, hard light of suspicion directly on the prop master. This would not be the first time a faulty or misused prop would lead to a hospital visit.
The prop store. Vital to every production, and this one was no exception. Please do come in, Mr. Bannon. Does the name Cedric Sloane mean anything to you?
Not really, should it?
Well, perhaps. From what we could dig up, he was the prop master during the making of Dying is Another Man's Job. Very vital, though, would you not agree, Mr. Bannon?
I suppose so, it would be, wouldn't it?
Not only that, but he was a military man, dishonorably discharged, no family to talk of, no friends, just his work, and then the accident.
Yes, you're right, I remember now. Something about him making a prop was too heavy, and then that could have been the reason Brent failed or something.
Ah, so you do. Mr. Bannon. Well, the stories surrounding Mr. Sloane are intriguing, to say the very least. We do know that there was no love lost between him and your father. From what we can tell, Cedric Sloane claimed that Mr. Bannon Sr. looked down on him and the rest of the crew, believing he was too good for them. Now, that kind of attitude breeds resentment. And if there's enough resentment, that can attract some very nasty spirits, Mr. Bannon.
No, I'm not sure any of this is fair on my father. I think by all accounts, he didn't even know that man existed. It's hard to look down on someone you don't even talk to.
But wasn't it true? The props were your father's idea. He insisted the stuntman keep them on him during the climb, despite their exuberance.
I think we can all agree that the character of Percival Pell would have been a bit lesser if it hadn't been for his signature dumbbells. I challenge you, mate, to look heroic without performing a quick bicep curl.
Signature indeed, though, perhaps signing a potential death warrant rather than creating the iconic story your father wanted. After all, with all these props lying around, there was ample opportunity for Cedric Sloane to exact his revenge, if that's what he wanted.
Yeah, well, it was an accident, that's why everyone decided, didn't they?
But... Ah, but was it the truth, Mr. Bannon, or is something more sinister at work here? I think we need to dig a little deeper to find it out, and we may be about to get some help with that.
Oh,
we getting this, don't we? We're getting this. My God.
It looks like what a jellyfish would see. On acid.
They're showing us something.
Some sort of light?
Yes, light. There's only one place in this building with lots of light.
The stage.
Exactly. Quickly. The departed are not patient.
Three, two, one, go.
The stage. The location of Brent Backflip's failed stunt, where he plunged to the ground below. It is situated above the long-sealed vault and the dark secrets he contains. This is where the cameras would roll, both figuratively and literally, at least until the installation of breaks.
Three, two, one.
Of course, the spirit would lead us here, the scene of the accident. This is where he wants us to find something. Perhaps the spirit is the unfortunate Brent himself.
That's probably a bit unlikely, mate. He lives near me. I saw him on Thursday. I'm pretty sure he was buying a shitload of toilet roll and a jazz mag.
Ah, yes. Well, the fall wasn't fatal.
Only to his career. The inebriated idiot never worked again. Serves him right.
Well, this is where the stunt failed, isn't it, Patrick?
Yes. He was supposed to be scaling that building when he fell and broke both his legs.
I'm sensing that, yes. I'm getting a bit of tibia over here and a bit of fibula over there. And yes, patella, I know you're there.
Okay. Right, Wayne, what are we doing here?
Well, this is our final stop, so it must mean something. There's normally something they want us to find, Patrick, okay? Something will answer our questions. Have a look, Patrick. Yes, all right, I'm getting it. There's something there beneath the carpet, something important.
No.
No, fit there. Bring it over here, Patrick.
Appears to be Brent Backflip's wallet, inexplicably.
Unbelievable! The aura! The aura! Yes, yes, it's powerful. Oh, I'm gonna try something here, okay? It's a bit dangerous, but don't worry, I have a spirit keeper protecting me from harm. Ah, shit.
Oh, shit.
Ah! Patrick! Patrick! It's me, Brent!
Oh my god.
I'm taking over this vessel. This is a possession.
Is that what it is? Oh god, Christ. Okay, are you alright in there, Wayne? Are you okay?
Ah, your elegant friend is safe and well. I maybe use me to cover the name. I wasn't at fault, Patrick. I wasn't at fault.
No! Don't you give me that bullshit, please, Brent!
Me wallet, Pat!
Don't call me Pat!
Me wallet!
Oh, Christ.
Check me, Wallace. Oh, what happened there? What did he say?
Not sure, very confusing. It was very strange. He spoke in an accent I didn't recognise at all.
Yeah, but that can happen.
Right, yeah. He said something about the wallet. Check the wallet. What
devilish things could such a rogue keep hidden there?
Right, looks to me like a 10-year sobriety chip. Letter to his loving mother, half finished. Photograph, lots of very attractive men, all looking happy together. Newspaper clipping, local man champion safety at work. But what could it all mean?
Well, if you ask me, sounds like we were wrong about Brent. Terribly wrong.
So what caused the accident then?
Well, I don't know. I didn't bring us here. Seems like we may have hit a dead end there, Patrick. The energy in this space is one of frustration. Perhaps just another unsolved mystery.
Damn this curse!
Yeah, well, I'm sure we'll have more luck with our next mystery, but first, we'd like to show the viewers at home a clip from a never-before-aired documentary.
Because my father originally ordered it cancelled. Out of respect.
The footage was itself damaged in the fire. The very fire we'll be investigating in just a minute. So,
stand by to play the footage.
Roll the tape.
I'm your host, Harold Repartee, and this is the nation's Nightfall Report. Tonight we bring you a special program where we take a closer look behind the scenes of a forthcoming television sensation.
Oh.
Masterminded by Graham Bannon,
Senior. Come on.
It's a shame all the film reels were damaged in the fire. Think what we could learn if we could fix them. Entertainment.
Bannon has just completed construction on this state-of-the-art studio and production facility.
Patrick Bannon, am I not?
Yes.
And I haven't changed at all, has it? I mean, it wasn't like Patrick 1 second, then not Patrick the next, or anything
with
like that.
With the price tag into the millions, it's a move that has raised eyebrows across the business world.
So who around here do you think might be the authority on exactly what Bannon's temperature might be?
Rehearsals are now well underway here, and it seems Bannon is quite the task master.
Yeah, close enough, it would seem. So why don't you take that off? Go on, hop on over there, have another go.
Honestly, he does it every single time. I think it never would have a watch.
I said not to touch that. Seriously, just leave it alone. Oh, well, yeah, that's exactly it. Just don't do it again.
Yeah, touch that.
Thank you, Doctor. I just wish he'd spend a little less time tinkering on his ridiculous new shoes and more on filming the show.
But if the executive's queuing around the block or anything to go by, these new scripts of his must be really something.
Okay, let's just start. Mr. Bannon, over here, if you would. Welcome back to Live and Spooky. Before the break, we explored a number of rooms in this old building, the long abandoned Bannon soundstage. And while the spirit world is ever present, it can only be felt in certain places and at certain times.
So what exactly caused the accident then, Wayne?
Well, Mr. Bannon, while we did follow some spectral signs during our preliminary investigations, we were unfortunately unable to discover the true cause of the accident so long ago that marked the beginning of Graham Bannon's woes. And normally, the spirit world uses a couple of signs to point us in the right direction before finally revealing their message for us.
Yeah, it's a shame we didn't find out what caused the accident. They normally find something in the final room.
Communication and conveyance.
Indeed, and it's there that this trick lets us down, but it has been known to happen on rare occasions. I am confident, however, that we'll be able to uncover the truth of the fire, the next unlucky event in the production's history.
Yes, it was never actually proven at the time, but blame was unofficially placed on Marie Murphy, the costume girl, who sadly was found dead shortly after on these premises. Hopefully tonight, we'll be able to find out exactly why.
Planning on finding some clearer talking ghosts, are we, Wayne?
Well, funny you should ask, Patrick, as you might be the one they're talking to. Thanks to Dr. Ahmed's incredible ingenuity, we now have the ability to cover the rest of the building, not one room at a time, but simultaneously.
Oh yeah, Alex, if you don't calibrate the spirit jam correctly by the time that bar fills up, Gareth, the polarity will become misaligned, and it'll take a while for it to restabilize and get back up and running again.
There's a built-in light service over here, should you find the need for it. Should you run into any darker environments?
Excellent, Doctor. Thank you. No, I'm hearing something. Yes, the great beyond is asking for you, my pet. Come over here. Yes. You're the one we need. I'm quite certain of it. What a pleasure it is to be joined by this lovely creature. At the moment I saw her, I just knew she'd be wanted here. By the spirit, of course. What's your name, darling?
My name's Holly.
And what is it you do normally, Holly?
I'm Patrick's... Mr. Bannon's assistant. I'm his long-suffering, ever-so-understanding assistant. Though, to be honest, it's probably because nobody else wanted the job.
Well, I have a feeling that you might even be integral to tonight's event. But don't worry, there is nothing to be nervous about, look. Dr. Ahmed and I are professionals. We've been
doing this for
years, and...
they are from spiritual interference. They're nice and calm and green, so no problems there.
Okay. Hello?
You're back.
I've had says to come downstairs.
AXA?
Dark on my own.
So much over here.
Ali, you can do it. It's just...
like the river Styx.
To be in a sort of... if you can see this, in a sort of lighting thing now. Okay. Can't much longer, can it? I've got... there's that. Can you see this? Oh, God. Hello?
You don't
go towards the light, do you? You don't go towards the light. That's probably not what we wanted to do anyway, so... Okay, I'm going off.
Are you part of the set?
Before, it's very dark, I can tell you.
But
although good television.
I don't think I'm very good at this.
Okay, guess I'm focusing. Focus.
Red. Sacrifice one, or I'll take the last.
Oh shit. Yeah, is it?
There is no such thing as ghost. This is something.
Wait. Hey, give me. Wait, am I choosing? Am I accidentally indirectly choosing who's dying?
No, I must have been imagining it. No. Okay. Okay.
Oh, I hope he really does have a spirit protector.
Oh, I wonder if any of this holds any spiritual energy as well. Normally, the bigger part of the equipment tends to hold much, much bigger presence.
So production.
Raiders go off the
chain. Okay!
These were all used back in the day in the Cursed Show. Grant Bannon, Marie Murphy.
Wait, I
think I see some lights.
Huh! Next try! No. I'm not sacrificing any of them! Thank you, ghost!
I think I'm gonna go. Because there's some equipment that will take a better reading. Okay, let's head back and see what we can get.
Okay. This is a game of cat and mouse, but the cat always wins.
Yeah, that was poor timing on your part, bud.
Corner, I tell you, because there's some lights there, and I'm not sure what it is.
What was it? No.
Just me with the camera.
You can't save them all.
Wait, what do you mean?
I tell you, this is very exciting, but I'm a little
what?
Bit nervous.
No.
The shape of the light. I think I'm gonna go towards it. It
no.
Looks like a warm, welcoming light.
Oh shit. Oh.
Here. Calm down, yeah? Calm down. That's it, good. Yes, hello. All right, darling. I'm here, okay? No, 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 this isn't what we discussed. Calm, yeah? We're all... No, no, that's not very nice, is it? Ta very. Now, how can I help you? Well, don't go all silent on me. The sulking isn't gonna help, is it? Talk to me.
Oh.
Better. So, I'm getting peace, yeah? Is that right? Peace?
Did I accidentally choose who lives and dies?
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that.
Yeah. Get the bars, white, get the bars.
I can't believe it.
Oh no, 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 no.
Oh, these EMF readers are off the charts to get. Oh, I think there's a ghost. Some kind of spiritual energy through there. I think that door opened by itself.
Yeah!
There's a lot of spiritual energy here, so I think we're gonna go.
Polly.
Okay, that is not the way out.
Okay, apparently I do choose who lives the night.
Where the fuck am I going?
Please stop testing me. I can't.
You just saw that as well, right? Oh, fuck. Nope. I did not sign up for this shit. I'm gonna find a different way.
Right, well, that's mental. If you can see the prong. Terrifying. Oh, God. I can't remember. Not worth it. And this dust, everything is caked in dust. So this is fucking ridiculous.
Oh, fuck. Oh no, we lost another one.
Hello? Spirit, you in here? Or phantom or spectre or whatever you like to be called. Oh, okay. Guess I better go investigate this then. Okay. What have we over here? Typewriter, lamp, boxes, fork in a little box, books and, script for Dying is Another Man's Job, written by, oh, that's funny. Okay, yeah, I'm pretty much done now, thank you very much. No more scary things for me, thank you, I will be off. Aha, you've locked the door, haven't you? Very funny, that's very funny, but I will be going, thank you so, please open up. Yes. You're trying to scare me and it's not working! So, you find your fun, let me out! Who the fuck did that? No, I'm done, thank you, no more of this bullshit! That was close.
Oh.
Patrick?
Come on, leave the assistant out of this.
Patrick? No, don't be stupid. Okay, you can do this. It's just a show. I seem to be going through one of the hallways this could lead to. Any one of the rooms.
Oh no. Oh no, last one! No! Don't tell me. Wait, focus.
Oh, okay, I think I hear. It sounds like Patrick. Oh, Mr. Bannon? Mr. Bannon, can you hear me?
No.
The last is mine.
No! Fuck you!
think.
Oh, the bolt broke, yeah. Oh.
Let's go and have a look. Mr. Bannon? Are you in here, Mr. Bannon? You sounded in distress. I could have sworn I saw him in here. Definitely residual readings in here somehow, but maybe they took him into don't worry, Mr. Bannon. We're coming for you. I don't understand. There could be some kind of. You're a liar!
Put your voice down when you're causing a scene.
No! This is not what we agreed, Gray.
This arrangement is better for us both.
Is it? Because I fail to see how I'm better off.
I'm doing you a fucking favor. You should be paying me for an opportunity like this. Us money is normal money.
I don't care about money. I want what I deserve, Graham.
Exactly what you deserve.
I'll tell them.
And who'll believe you? Seriously, who will believe you, Marie? You're a woman.
Yeah, I am. At least I'm not a fraud.
You won't last long, won't you, Marie?
Oh, fuck this shit. No, I don't want to be here. There's no such thing as ghosts. There's no such thing as ghosts.
No, I would have rather sacrifice Ganon.
Okay, Holly. You can do this. And just open your eyes. On three. One. Two. Three. See? It's fine. Nothing happened.
It's very bad. Well.
If anyone finds this later, if I don't get out, here's what I know, or at least what I'm guessing. I seem to have gotten into the projection room. There's some storage over here. On what looks like the remnants of the fire. This is where they burnt the tapes and the scripts. Oh my god. Wow. Strange that it's still here after all this time. I mean, I don't want to clean up a haunted building either. As requested, we've gathered all original manuscripts for you, even copies previously taken off site. We hope. Oh. Why would somebody want all the copies brought together? Well, too late for that question, I guess, now. No, I wonder if this thing actually works. Wow! Oh my god, it must have been so cool to watch stuff on this back in the day. Oh, wow. So cool. Hang on. Is that Graham?
Oh, Patrick.
It's so good, I put my banner name on it. How could you go anywhere else? You couldn't. Not without banners. And that's a banner promise you can trust. In fact,
hold off any ghosts. Oh God, what am I doing here? In all my years as being his PA, this has to be the most ridiculous thing I've had to do. Still, I hope he's all right, I guess. And the others, I just wish this was over. Look, I don't know what's going on, and I don't want to be here. If that doesn't happen, and somebody finds this later, I suppose I better sign off. The battery's dying and this is my only light. My name is Holly.
Take a closer look here at the television project sensation. Things are really not as they seem. How could you trust? Bannon, there's no rest for the wicked.
Jesus Christ on a bike, that was a ride. Oh, this must be the vault below the stage. Greetings, my friends. If you're still with us, you join me here in the very room where Marie Murphy took her own life and sealed the fate in these here walls. Welcome to the finale of tonight's Live and Spooky. Ah, this wasn't exactly as I expected to get here, but it's not unheard of for an entity to bring only those with the gift of clairvoyance to them. But of course, only I, Wayne the Spirit Whistle, will be able to communicate with them either in this world or their own. Marie, it is you, isn't it, Marie? Don't fear me, okay, love? I may be powerful, but I'm also speak through me, Marie, so I can put you to rest. Come on, we're up against the clock. Let's not upset the advertisers. That's all we have time for. Just fucking fuck! I think that was actually some spirit shit there. Okay. So, Graham Bannon was there, but he didn't stop it. Holy shite. Oh my word, this is gold. You've struck gold, Wayne. Oh, okay, Marie, I hear you. I understand you. Don't you worry. I'll make sure this film is put to good use.
Extremely good use.
So, I'll leave you to it then, okay, love? No harm done. Just let me out and we'll fix it, yeah? No? No. No, please. No, I'm sorry. It was just a bit of a laugh. Just entertainment. I didn't mean any harm, honestly. I really didn't. Hey, look, take it. Take it. It's yours. I don't want it.
Percy, I can't believe you came.
Only came to say goodbye.
Goodbye?
That's what I said, ain't it?
What about your manuscript?
I couldn't have done it without you.
Do you really mean that?
You calling me a liar, kid?
I can't tell you how happy that makes me.
Well, I guess this is it.
Must I go?
This is the way it has to be. But remember, I'll never forget you, Mary.
Do you promise?
Cross my heart and hope to die. And dying is another man's job.
Oh, hello. Okay, so... let you guys figure out some of the secrets we missed. Because I'm not doing that again that first act as well. Alright.
Dying is another man's job. Crying is another man's job. When country calls, he stands up tall and proud.
Bye.
Tonight on Channel 1, I'm going to be grouting with pop star Skinny.
And I'm going to be showing Arthur and Katie from the Sunny Happy Playhouse team how to tell their bits from their pieces.
So be sure to tune in to Channel 1 tonight for a new improved season of Just the Job. Tonight at 9 p.m.
Good evening.